Hi guys, it's Ruben here, and welcome to my Mass Effect Andromeda Insanity Mode walkthrough. And in this one, I'm going to be featuring the final mission of the game, and it's called Meridian, The Way Home. Now, this mission is what I consider to be one of the longest missions in the game, and it also features a immense amount of enemies. What I mean is, you're going to be going through waves and waves and waves of remnants and cats. So make sure you have the appropriate setup. From the previous video, I showed my loadout. I didn't really change much. All I did was I changed my Black Widow sniper rifle. I basically changed it to another one, which just had a higher damage. The one mistake I made was I forgot to take off the electrical conduit, so it still only shoots one bullet at a time and I have to reload, so I will not be using my sniper rifle at all. I've also added a different augment to my Scorpion, which shoots sticky grenades. All I did was I changed it to include penetration damage, and that's pretty much it for my loadout. Everything else you're seeing in terms of skills, my teammates, they're all the same. If anything, I just upgraded their abilities and, you know, upgraded my armor, and that's pretty much it. Now, this first sequence, you're going to be back on Meridian and you're going to be fighting a lot of remnants. You're going to have two nullifiers that you have to take out. At this point, they're not too much of a threat. I have my remnant Mark 6. And it's very powerful. So once you're done that sequence and you go through a lot of story exposition, you're going to get to play as your other twin. You're going to get to play as the other twin. In my case, it's Sarah Ryder. And guys, you need to be careful here. She doesn't have any abilities. You might be whatever level you are at in terms of, you know, I was level 40 something. But you won't get any abilities, and you're going to be stuck with your starting pistol, which is the Predator. Now, it's going to be upgraded to, a little bit higher. You might have Predator 5, Predator 4, whatever. It doesn't really matter. You're only limited to a pistol, and you get one grenade. So use it effectively. I wasted my grenade, so it turns out that all I'm going to be doing right now is going to be peeking at a cover and shooting them, you know, hopefully going for the headshots. I actually don't, because I suck. But anyways, it's just very jarring when you have so many abilities and all of a sudden they take it out and you're just left with, I don't know, a crappy pistol. Use the third person cover trick, you know, shoot around the, you know, outside and around the door, just like in Wanted, curve the bullets. You can still get hit because this game has a tendency to poke you. Like, right there, I'm trying to shoot around the corner and she sticks her head out. I mean, in other games it feels intuitive, but I just wanna, you know, just shoot the enemy and move on, and it won't let me do that. Which I find really awkward. It's just like, come on, I just wanna shoot around the corner. So sometimes you want to back away from the cover, just in case if you want to try this method. But other than that, it's not too difficult, because every time you fight enemies as Sarah or your counterpart, you know, Scott, whoever, your counter twin, you're only going to be fighting two enemies at a time, so you can just pretty much hide. Now the next sequence, you don't have to fight them. You can completely skip this entire fight. All you have to do is run to that door. The moment she says go to the door, just dash through or run through to the door, open it, and you're pretty much done the sequence. All you have to do is go and talk to Sam, and that's it. Go and engage Sam, and you're pretty much done the mission. Well, not the mission, you're done with Sarah. And after that, you're going to be landing on Meridian, and you're going to be using your Nomad. And I thought there'd be a cool like chase sequence, fighting sequence, but no. This is just a spectacle. You're just running around looking at the pretty grass, pretty mountainside, pretty everything. And you're just gonna be driving. There's nothing interesting to engage you with, so it's not like it's challenging. I'm just showing this sequence just because I don't know, it was different enough, I guess. So the moment you come in front of the structure, you're gonna be fighting some cat. Now, again, nothing too difficult, nothing too strenuous in my opinion. Once in a while, you'll fight a destined with the shields and they go through the miss, but at this point, I know what my abilities are. I know what my capabilities are in terms of how to deal with them. So, yeah, I use it effectively. The overload plus my EMP plus the electric gun is just a really powerful combo. Your teammates, my teammates at this point, are really, really strong. When they engage enemies, they basically shred them down to death, to shreds. So, at this point, I thought I could skip this entire sequence by, just jumping away from the combat scenario from the right. There are enemies to the right. There'll be more enemies that'll be dropping from the dropship. Now, essentially, I thought, I could skip this fight because, come on, it's just more fighting. And how unpleasantly was I surprised? You can't go through. You have to fight all the enemies, and that is going to be a theme of this mission, because there will be tons of enemies you'll have to fight, and you can't skip sequences. You have to defeat every enemy. It specifically states defeat all cat that remaining in every sequence you come across. I feel like it's an archaic design choice, because if you give me the ability to stealth past enemies, I feel like you should at least make it or design it in a way where, it complements that situation. Like, they give you this cloaking ability, it's completely useless in terms of stealthing, because, once you have stronger weapons, you really don't need to stealth, unless, you don't have too much health or too much shields, whatever. But you guys may be wondering why this is mission 9. This is labeled as Mission 9, and the one before this, the Journey to Meridian, was labeled Mission 8. There are other missions that came up. One was to travel to this asteroid, and it, H7-04 something. I forget it was. And it was a priority op. And there was another one, it was called, traveling to Illadin. It's a different planet. Now, I initially thought that those will be, giant sequences, giant missions with combat scenarios, but no, basically the priority op is just for you to go land on these, on this asteroid and this planet, and then those two missions end. There's literally one objective, just to go land on them, and that's it. So I thought it was pointless to feature it. I thought it was pointless to even call it a mission. It feels like an objective to a larger mission, you know what I mean? So I didn't feature those. It's not even required really to do the main story, so that's why I'm calling the previous mission and this mission the final two missions. And now that's out of the way, guys. Nothing new. Everything we're going to be facing is things we've already seen. Nothing new in this mission or the last few missions, and I feel like that's a step back in my opinion, because you go through this gauntlet of enemies, everywhere. And once you get to the final door, you'd think you'd end up with a boss fight. And it's not. There is no boss fight in this game. Which is extremely disappointing, because you have this giant monster. It's called the Architect. And you see this in Eos. And you see this in Vold. And you also see this in Illadin, and you have the ability to fight them in side missions once you do enough side missions. Now, I've never fought one of these, just because on Insanity they literally kill me in one or two shots, and I'm just like, whatever, I'll just finish the story and come back later. And guess what? This mission finally features an Architect. It's just giant worm, and I thought I'll get to fight it. No, it's just a... it's just there, it's just there randomly shooting at you, randomly engaging you, but you don't need to fight it. All you need to do is fight waves and waves of enemies, and then once you finish those waves, you just go interact with a, you know, an object, a console, and then that's it. The mission just ends unceremoniously. No boss fight. Sure, there might be a small payoff in terms of the story, there's a small resolution, but come on, in a gameplay standpoint, I really expected that architect or that fight to be more. It's really disappointing, guys. The end of this mission is, in terms of a gameplay scenario, is one of the most disappointing things I've ever seen. I mean, I thought we'd fight the main antagonist of the game. You don't. You even got to fight his commander, the Archon Sword, in the previous mission. You know, that was a cool fight. It wasn't anything too difficult to figure out. I mean, there's waves of enemies protecting him and stuff like that, but it was still something. It was still a boss fight. But this game, this mission, right now, I would suggest that you use Don't Do What I Just Oh god. Yeah, my mistake. You don't die, you lose like half your health, and if you're just with my chest piece that I'm wearing, the Remnant chest piece, it regens health to a certain point, so I wasn't too worried about that. Now my teammate is down at the moment, so, you know, I could go to help her out. And Drac. Drac is down too. So at this point, Drac went down. I'm just like, okay, time to move. So shield. Cloak. You see how effective that is? And this is where the engineer comes into play. You see how when I move close in, the destined enemy got stunned. If, say for instance, I didn't have engineer, what would happen is that destined enemy would punch me out of the reviving animation. And that's why I feel the engineer is so overpowered, it's so useful, because for situations where you need to go pick up ammo, for situations where you need to engage an enemy close hand, you know, just so you can do a tech combo or a, you know, a primer, it's very effective. And right here, Drax just standing while he's down, which is great. So right there, I do a tech combo. And another important aspect of this game is shooting over cover, guys. I cannot stress how important that is. You know, you can mitigate a lot of damage that you take by just shooting over the cover, and if they come close, go cloak and run away. So right now, the remnants start coming in. I initially thought that they'd, you know, you'd be in the scenario where it would be like a three-way fight where the cat will be fighting the remnant and you, and you know, you the same way. But it's not really like that. Once a cat remnants see you, they will stop engaging the cat and they will just actively fight you. So, you know, don't trust the enemy's engagements. Always think that everything is your enemy. So right after this fight, you're gonna have to walk through a couple areas and activate a couple consoles, go through bridges, and once you get to the next area, you're gonna fight an ascendant, a couple anointed, destined, the usual bunch of cat enemies. As I said, there's not much variety. It's usually the cat and the remnants that you fight throughout the story. You're not gonna fight the raiders or any animals. You will fight one animal in this mission, which I completely skipped because I didn't feel like fighting them. So right now, there is the Ascendant. You want to take out all the enemies first, just because you know how annoying the Ascendant can be. Even if you try to engage her, once her Ascendant Orb comes off, or you take it down, she'll just revive it within 5 seconds, and during that 5 seconds, it's not enough time to do the amount of damage necessary to take her down quickly. Instead, if you focus on killing all the enemies first, then all you're left with is her, and you can give your undivided attention towards her. So right now, I feel like I have nothing to say right now, because it's stuff that we've done before, stuff that necessarily doesn't need any more explanations because we've done it so many times. We've faced these enemies and this combination so many times that it's kind of pointless to talk further. So what I will do is I will talk about what's coming up in terms of the final sequence. There is going to be a lot of enemies. Lot. I should think there are going to be a lot of enemies in that sequence. The enemies aren't only going to come from one side. They randomly get created. They can randomly get assembled by assemblers from every single direction. So you're going to look at getting hit from the left, the right, backside, and you're also going to have to deal with the architect. The architect only has two moves, to what I've seen. The first one is a AoE. It pre-projects a red field, and if you're caught in that red field, swarms of smaller like drones come and attack you. And if you're caught in that radius for far too long, you will instantly die because your shield will come off, and then that's it. A couple hits, you're dead. The second hit, move that the architect can do is shoot electrical orbs, say 4 or 5. What it does is it shoots the spread of, I'd say, grenades. It looks like grenades because that's the kind of indicator that you get on the screen. And if you're stuck in those areas, the architect will shoot electrical orbs towards those areas that it's marked. So basically you get hit by it. And let me tell you, you do not want to get hit by one of those electrical orbs. They will instantly kill you. I don't know how much health I have, but I know for a fact I died like once because of that. It just instantly killed me. But right now, you ascend it. That's all that's left. Make sure to, target your team. Make sure you target her with your teams. Your team's actively taking her attention away. Its attention away. And also I'm using my remnant, and the remnant does a lot of damage. And the reason I like the remnant over the turret is because of its self-healing abilities. It heals by itself. If it takes enough damage, it backs off. You can make it go somewhere else. It will heal by itself and it will always stay there. So it's a very, very useful. I would call it the upgraded turret in my opinion. But other than that, nothing really to say about this fight. It's going to take a long time, as expected, because BioWare loves giving its enemies, so much health, and you can't do crap about it. But I think I tried to show off the ability to chain stun her with the EMP from the engineer's profile and the overload. So what I do here is once the ascendance orb takes enough damage and it breaks, she's going to be left defenseless. So what you want to do is you want to shoot as many bullets as you can, I'd say for 2-3 seconds, and right after that you want to walk towards her. If you're using this expression, this profile, say if you walk towards her, see, it releases an EMP and she's stunned again, and you can combo that. Now, I made a mistake there I killed her, but what you want to do is you don't want to immediately release your overload. You want to shoot a little bit until that EMP starts wearing off a little bit, and then right as soon as she recovers, you want to release your overload. You want to hit her with overload to stun her over again. As I said in the previous video, I have killed an Ascendant by chaining this over and over till she died, and I wish I recorded this, because I was never able to do it again. I would just always mess up the timing. It's like something you have to innately know, otherwise you're gonna mess it up. But it can be done. At least if you do it correctly, if you do it in a way that you remember them or you know the timings, you can take that her out within the first orb. After you destroy the orb the first time, she would die. But what can you do? I made a mistake, and there was never any other chance to fight her. Actually, you fight her one more time, but it's in this sequence where if you dash towards or dash left and right, you fall off the edge, and I really didn't want to try it out in a situation like that. It was at the final room. So right now, there's a couple enemies, and when you come up here, a fiend is going to spawn. And to make matters worse, I believe a destroyer is going to spawn. You definitely, definitely do not want to be here. Is it a destroyer? I could be wrong, but I wanted to just let my teammate handle it to see if there's any extra stuff that you can get. There obviously is. There always is. So I come down, and I'm looking down, and I see a destroyer, and I'm just like, nope, I'm out. So I get super lucky here, because I activate the gravity well, and I take a lot of damage. I should have died there, but I'm not complaining. Well, in any case, in this sequence, you're tasked to follow the way these remnant models are facing. And that's all you want to do. You want to just follow this path quickly. My first time, I'm just like, what's happening? And then that's because I was playing with no sound, because it was late. And then I realized, you know, whoever your teammates are, they'll be like, they'll actually notify you and say, oh, look, the remnant's facing this way. We should go this way. You follow it. Once you get to that door, that's it. You're at the boss room. Well, I call it boss room. It's pretty much the final room. There's no boss in this game. I'm so pissed off about that. So this is a sequence where an ascendant will spawn, and you'll have, you know, your usual bunch of cat enemies to fight. It's nothing. I'm not gonna say if it's difficult or not. Okay, for some people will be, for some people won't. I feel I was a little bit over leveled in this situation just because I did every side mission possible. Not everything, but enough to get all planets' viability to 100%. And I settled all the outposts, I did all the loyalty missions. You know what I mean, it gives you enough experience. I think I was, what, level 43, 44? So obviously I was powerful enough to have all these really overpowered abilities. And I felt my engineer class was just too, it's just wrecks enemies in my opinion. But just let your teammates handle them, because they're very capable at this point. In the beginning of the game, they die really quickly, but in this sequence, I'm actually really happy with what my teammates can do. I really wish we had the ability to, you know, to command what abilities they use. BioWare just felt it wasn't necessary. Just let the teammates handle it. They know when to choose the right move. Like, at this moment, all I want Cora to do is to give a shield boost, but she won't. She'll just look at her. She just went in for a punch. Nice. Amazing. At this point, I want Drax to use a flak cannon shot to take that thing down. But he won't. He'll incinerate her. Why not, right? Oh, this game. They give... I'm not going to criticize this game in terms of its combat. I feel the combat is the best part about this game. There's so much customizability, so many different powers to experiment with. You know, they've taken the class system out, and you can basically have any power you want. So I feel like all that is a plus. The problem is, why? Why take out the ability to command what skill that your teammates use? Because right now, when I target my teammates to that enemy, they do whatever they want. I can't tell them to specifically hit them. I can't tell them to use a specific power. You know, even when you try to point to some cover and say, go take cover there, they're going to take cover, but then they're also just going to peep out. Like, they're going to go there. They're going to sit there for like 2 seconds, and then they're going to come out of the cover. And it's like, why? The teammates AI definitely needs tweaking, but other than that, you know, they do a good job of taking the enemy's attention. So what I'm doing right now is using my scorpion to see. See, I finally learned my scorpion can do a lot of damage to that eye, and now its shield is down. So right now I come close, I activate my overload. I mean, my EMP, I activate my overload. Look how much damage I can do while stunning it over and over. I got lucky because I just kept shooting far too long. I should have, you know. I don't have the control, guys. I get really pissed off really quick. I get pissed off really quickly. I get annoyed really quickly, and I just don't have the patience when enemies are bullet sponge. I feel like if you're skilled enough and you have the right combo, right weapon, you should be decimating enemies. And the game doesn't. That is one of the, I don't know, cons of having it as an RPG, which this game doesn't have much of an RPG system, in my opinion. It's just, oh look, I fell off. I told you. be careful when you dodge in this area, you will fall off. But compared to other Mass Effects, I feel like this one has a weaker RPG system, in my opinion. I don't know, it's just me. But yeah, so just, I think I take her out in the sequence. Yeah, I stun her one more time and that's it, she's done. So after that sequence, you're gonna go through a cutscene, and this is it, guys. This is the final sequence, and this is gonna be about, gonna take the next 15 minutes to do. But in reality, it took me about an hour because I just didn't understand the amount of enemies they put up on you. So the architect, did you see that red area that it highlighted? That's where you want to be careful, because if you get trapped in there, you'll get swarmed by these drones and they will definitely take your health out. So in this sequence, they spawn a ton of enemies. You know, observers, nullifier, assemblers, the assemblers will spawn breakers. You remember, you get it, right? The problem is, they ask you to go activate a console. Now, in many missions, when they've done this, I took my cloak ability, I turned it on, and I went straight to the objective and I activated it. But in this one, no, you can't do that. When you get to the objective, it says defeat all the remaining enemies before you activate it. Why? I don't get it. If you are skilled enough, if you are, you know, smart enough to find a way to reach there without, you know, dying, I feel like it should give you the option to go and turn it off or turn on the console. The game doesn't allow that. It wants you to spend a ton of time just fighting these generic enemies that we've already fought like 100 times before. And they expect you to kill all of them. Sometimes you can. Sometimes if you don't have the right abilities, like if I didn't have the cloak, I don't know how I would get out of these sequences, because you're going to be swarmed by enemies from everywhere. It's unbelievable. And how are you supposed to revive your teammates if you don't have the cloak? So, like, if someone knows, please leave a comment, because I'd like to know. I'd actually like to know what abilities can you use to go revive a teammate, you know, safely. I think the cloaking is the best one, in my opinion. So right there is the area where you need to be when you want to activate that machine or that console. But, you know, don't stay in one area too long, guys. You'll definitely get overwhelmed. And the architect doesn't make life easier. I tried to pick up that stuff, and instead my Asari sword came out of nowhere. Wonderful. Well, in any case, you can't damage the architect in the sequence. I tried. You saw me in the beginning. I tried shooting. Didn't really work out. But this is it. It's waves and waves of enemies. And you'd think after, you know, you beat all these enemies, you can just go activate the machine. No. It becomes a defense mission at that point. You activate the machine and it says, defend until the hack procedure is done. It's you know, it's taking 2 minutes, arbitrary 2 minutes, or however long it takes when you're inside that defense circle for that mission to fill up, the mission bar. Which, it's such an archaic system, in my opinion. It's You just went through waves of enemies. Why do you have to defend it? We just killed all the enemies. Isn't this our defense? I mean, in a story aspect, it makes sense, but doesn't necessarily translate well when it comes to gameplay. So right now, the moment you activate that machine, you want to get out of there because the architect will immediately shoot those electric orbs just right there. You have to stay inside this circle, guys, otherwise the bar will never fill up. So my strategy was to go into cover, and if I can't, oh my god, that red beam. It just takes way too long. Well, anyways, back in the circle, and the enemies won't engage you in the sense, like, they're not like the cat enemies where they will come straight up to you and then shoot you. They're happy to stay far away and shoot you from there. So what you want to do is just circle the machine around, and if you're getting shot, go hide in a corner, or go hide by taking cover. And if you get shot in, you know, in cover, activate your cloak, and you pretty much can finish the sequence. So once I activate this console, it tells me to go back. I died in this sequence because I spent the next 10 minutes going to the next area where there's tons of enemies. I beat them, and then out of nowhere, more enemies spawn. Like, literally, there's no warning that they're gonna spawn. It just spawns while I was trying to jump through an area, and I immediately get shot by three enemies, and I die. 15 minutes, guys. Wasted. And in this sequence, I'm running it faster, you know? I'm being more risky. I'm shooting, I'm, you know, throwing stuff out. I'm being risky. That is the only word I can use. But, you know, at this point I know how many enemies there are. I know all the sequences. I know where they're going to come from. But the first time, there's no warning. It just spawns out of thin air, and because, you know, they're remnants. They can spawn out of thin air in this city. They just spawn out of thin air and they kill you. Be very careful. So right now, there's going to be a couple observers. The electric gun, its only limitation is that you have to be close by. Just because the arc has a tendency to just curve downwards. So right there, the architect comes in once in a while to attack you guys. At this point, you should know when the architect is going to come, just because of its predetermined position that it's going to shoot at or bite at or, you know, throw its stuff at. So right there, you saw me go in to activate my EMP from the engineer profile. I will do that quite a lot, just because I know I'll be able to survive it. So in this sequence isn't too rough in my opinion, because all it is enemies you've already seen before. You know, a couple observers, they have shields, use your teammates, and you should be fine. The next sequence is going to spawn a nullifier with a ton of observers, and oh man, well, we'll get there and we'll talk about that. A good ability to use in this sequence would be if you had the, I would say, singularity from the biotic tree. It'd be great to use it, and then you can combo that with a overload. But I went full tech in this sequence, in this walkthrough, just because, you know, I really wanted to use the turret. It felt like a third teammate, in my opinion. I really wanted to use my cloak, just in case I want to go revive enemies. Why would I do that? Revive teammates. And the overload just made sense in terms of, you know, taking shields out quickly. Otherwise, I don't know what I would have done. So right there, I took out the nullifier. The moment you come here, more enemies will spawn. I got absolutely wrecked the first time. I had no warning that the enemies will spawn, so, and I died. They literally shot me at the same time, all three enemies, and I basically died. So this time, I learned from that mistake, and I basically run back. The goal is to stay where you are and defend it or to kill the enemies, but I'm just like, nah. I'm gonna take my time, kill all the enemies, almost died there. Thank you, engineer profile, otherwise I would have been dead. If, for instance, those enemies were not stunned, I would have been dead instantly. So, if you guys are wondering whether or not to use the engineer, I would say use it. It's a very, very good profile, in my opinion. And I put a lot of ability points, or skill points, into my tech tree. So, it only further enhances the engineer profile. So that's pretty much it, guys. We're coming up at the end, the final sequence, which is basically once you cross that chasm, I call it chasm, but it'll spawn these ledges which you can jump onto. Once you cross it, it is your final sequence. You just have to defend that one area until all the enemies are dead. Once the enemies are dead, you activate the console, and you know, the architect would be neutralized. Once the architect's neutralized, well, he won't be neutralized. It's just, you're pretty much done the sequence, and all you have to do is go to a one final console and activate it, and the mission just ends. It is ridiculous, in my opinion, because I thought you would actually get to fight the antagonist. No, it just ends. So right now, did you see that? I needed to leave that in. But that happens a lot. I almost died again. But I died in this sequence. If you see that transition where I jump on the ledge and then it fades away, and then I come back and I'm doing another running jump, it's because I died in this sequence. I got to the final part where there's only like one enemy left, and I was trying to search for it, and the architect shot electrical orbs at me, and I died instantly, which was great. Because right now in the sequence, it's about, what, 7 minutes, 8 minutes, but I spent a good chunk of time in the previous, you know, attempt, just hiding, just to see what would happen, just to take it safe. But now I know how, you know, when enemies are going to come, what enemies are going to come, so I can be ready for them. So again, nothing too difficult in my opinion. You have a couple observers. So right there, when he targets that area, you want to hide on the back. You will take no damage at that point. Later on, say in a couple minutes after enemies thin out, I will stop taking cover in the back. I'll just take cover over there. The architect will hit me, and I will lose my shields, but my shields will instantly regenerate because I've set up my scenario like that, or my abilities like that. So right here, it's not too difficult. I mean, as long as you're taking cover. If you're not taking cover, you're gonna take a lot of damage. So right here, more enemy ships will come by. They'll drop more enemies. Sorry, never mind. You actually get help. You actually get teammates coming to help you. So you have one nullifier left, I think. And once you kill that enemy, more enemies will spawn. It's just over and over, you know. You're just going to see waves of enemies. And you can't really do anything about it. I just wish that we were able to go in and hit the button and end the mission, but you can't. Right there. You know, the architect will most likely just try to go for you. It always does go for you when you come pop your head out. But say if you're always hiding in the corner, it will aim for Drac and Korra, my teammates, but it'll probably aim for your teammates. Now, I don't know, in this sequence I thought there'll be since there are so many assemblers, they'll make a lot of breakers. And you know, I'm not wrong in thinking that way, because the breakers do spawn. It's just my teammates are really quick in dispatching breakers. They're like the lowest tier of enemies, and they go down pretty quickly. So the one problem I ran into is the fact that the observers will occasionally, you know, fly really high in the air, and you can't reach them. So you know, I would suggest using a different weapon to engage them. So once you get the prompt, or after the hacking is done, you can go and interface with the machine. I just said that because she said it. Well, once you activate this machine, I actually died in this sequence. Right after I activated it, they killed me. But you get a checkpoint. So at this point, all you want to do is run the way we came back and go interact with the machine or with the console. Once you interact with the console, the mission will end. And that's it. You're pretty much done in Sanity Mode. So congrats if you guys made it this far and you're able to finish it. It was tough in the beginning, but once you upgrade your powers, once you do all the side missions, it becomes really simple. Well, that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you guys like it. See you next time. Take care.